Hello friends, good afternoon all of you. So today we are in the last lecture of online workshop on modern construction materials. We have 8 lectures total in this workshop. First one was given by Mr. Anand Sinha of MIT University on nuclear shielding properties of concrete. It's a wonderful lecture, well described. Another one is the eco-friendly material lecture about green buildings and environmental friendly materials by Mr. Jaisingh Rajput, research scholar at MITS. And it's a very, it's the longest lecture, but it was really very interesting. Then we have a wonderful lecture by Mr. Amit Mathur sir, AGM Technical Services Wonder Cement, and he told us about the inside of the plant, which sometimes is very unfamiliar even for the students of civil engineering, that how the plant works and what are the techniques that we are using to manufacture any industrial material. So it is really a very good lecture for all of us to get the idea of the cement industry. Next, today morning we have a very well described lecture on wood as a construction material by Mr. Sushant Gupta, my colleague. He is working with us in our university, and he gave us the total idea about the wood as a construction material. And then we have with us Mrs. Priyanka Jain, SDO RES MP government, and he described and he tells us about the he told about the practical problems or the low cost materials, which is very important nowadays for the developing countries like India, because we want low cost materials and we want that techniques which is really very cost effective. So we want that kind of material so much, so it's a very good moment for all of us to take advantage of our experience. And then we have we had a lecture on tensile fabric structures by my colleague and friend Mr. Nishant Agrawal, and he is working on that material, and he did some projects also, and that is why he is more familiar with that that material, as tensile fabric structures are very new and nowadays it is extensively used in those areas where you want some kind of fancy materials with some kind of strength also. And then there is a lecture of my student of BE Architecture, Gautam Kalita, on aluminium. It's not planned, but it's a wonderful lecture, and he told us about the aluminium as a construction materials. And now in the last, I am telling you about the science and engineering of construction materials, which is very important. And now I think the question, some kind of questions that is arising through that workshop, that why we need to study materials and why we need to study material science or material engineering, or why there is a need of a research on materials so that we can utilize the best materials available in our country, or the best resources which is available in our country, in a very cost effective and a sustainable way. So in that way, material research is always a very interesting topic, and this topic or material research always encourages us to refine the materials and make the superior material that we are using nowadays. So material is the word that I think we need to explore a lot, because the one thing which is very important is that materials are probably more deep rooted in our culture than most of us realize. We realize that there is not that much value. We will not give that much value to some kind of materials. Like, we give value to money and to gold and some kind of precious metals, silver. But if we talk about steel, wood, they surround us. But I don't think they have that much kind of impact that we think. So in that way, materials are very much deep rooted, but we, I think we didn't realize in that sense. The another factor which I think it's very important to look into that there is a timeline of history. And if you look this slide, then timeline of material means if you classify the history, that is on the basis of the material. And it's really very interesting to know that history is divided on the basis of the materials. So, because it impacts our lives, it impacted a lot. Like if you talk about Stone Age, then at that age, all the activities is day-to-day life activities is all the strength of the human to change the world, and that is through the materials, his capability to use the materials. And this is the fact that always we judge any society or any civilization that is on the basis of the utilization of material, that how extensively they utilize that material, that is the basis to judge any advancement of that civilization. So it's very important. And because in the Stone Age we have only stone to use, we have only stone for the utensils, we have only stone for the arms and to do anything. And then we moved to metal, man uses metal, and then that age is known as the Bronze Age, and we have so many advancement. We know how to, because metals are more ductile than stone, as you all know. So then we can use more advanced and more sophisticated material from the metal. So in that way, the advancement of the society can be done only with the help of the material. Then we have the Iron Age, which is the iron, which is more stiff, and that have more strength than bronze, and which allow us to use more stiffer material, more stiffer arms, that has the capability to kill a very big animal, that has the capability to withstand at heat. So these kind of advancement changes the base, changes the capability of the society, because now they are using stone, they are using bronze, and now they have the idea of the iron also. So it changes a lot. And then we have medieval period. In that medieval period, we used alloys, we used so many, we used arms. Like in that way, there is a wood and there is a steel in those kind of era. So wood has a different work or different application, and steel has a different application. So in arms, because wood is more shock resistance as compared to the steel, so we applied both in the arms. We used wood as well as steel, because they both have different applications, and they both possesses different kind of properties. So this is all about the basic picture, that how material helps us to classify the history, or how material helps us to change the capability to use the Mother Earth, or to advancement, to do the advancement. Now specifically, if we talk about construction materials, then construction material is very old, as we all know. But in the olden times, we have only stone and wood as the construction materials. In the last century, when concrete came, we get more sophisticated, and we have that capability of making multi-story buildings, skyscrapers, and big dams. So concrete is the turning point to study any construction material. So concrete is one of the most important thing to study, and even today also, concrete the research on concrete is going on. We are adding something, we are subtracting something and making a new and the superior kind of concrete. So in the last century, we have only two or three materials, like we have steel, we have concrete, mortar. So with these materials, we saw the advancement. We saw the advancement in Europe. We saw the advancement in America, USSR at that time. So that is only on the basis of the material. In India, you can see Nehru ji described as the modern temples of modern India, our dams and all those things. Why? Because these dams are so important for us. It changes the picture of the farmers, and that can only be possible because now we have the ability to make the big dams and highways, because we have the ability to use the material. Okay, now in the modern era, we have more sophisticated materials, like we have polymers, we have composite, which have different faces. They are more sophisticated, they are more active, even micro in the terms of in the level of microstructure, they are more active. So that is why we need to study those kind of materials, and research is going on to investigate the hidden qualities, or to explore the material and to utilize the material as much as possible for the benefit of the society, or to make the best out of those materials. The next slide is about the backgrounds, that what is material science, what is material engineering, and what is material research. Material science involves the fundamental science and the understanding of the material and its behavior. Like, material science involves the fundamental science in the understanding of the material. If you want to study, or if you want to work on any material, if you want to apply any material, if you want to apply concrete, or if you want to apply any polymer, then it is very important that you have to study that material. You have to study that material in all level, like in the further slides I described those levels. Three levels are there. So we have to study from the fundamental level, that how the material behaves, or what are the pros and cons of different properties, what is the durability of the material. Durability is something which is very important nowadays, because we want durable material. Even in our day-to-day life, we saw that nowadays all the materials are so compact and so durable that people want durable material. In the construction industry also, our requirement is to make a durable material, which involves so much strength, and so much performance wise they are more superior if you want a durable material. And that is why to make the most precise material, you have to study at the fundamental sciences. Material engineering is something which controls the properties of the for the final use of the application. Like, material engineering is the control, you can say, because if you can control the material for the specific application, then it's very good, and you can achieve that target. If you are very much focused about the material, like if you want a concrete to work in a dam, or if you want a concrete to work in a pavement, or if you want a concrete to work in a simple house, the targets are totally different. The material is same, but the target is totally different. The properties are totally different. The concrete cannot behave, or it's not desired to behave in a pavement that in a dam. तो जिस तरीके से हम चाहते हैं कि कॉन्क्रीट बिहेव करे डैम में, वो नहीं करती है. उस तरीके से पेवमेंट में नहीं करती है, बिकॉज वी वॉन्ट डिफरेंट एप्लीकेशन. एंड दैट इज द रीजन वेयर यू कैन सी मटेरियल इंजीनियरिंग इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द अनदर थिंग इज मटेरियल रिसर्च. The material research is something which is which solves problem and create new products. Like suppose mild steel is the best example. We used mild steel a lot in past decades, but now we have new materials. We have Fe415, we have TMT. So the new products are the result of the material science and material engineering. Okay. Now the question arises, why do we need to study material science and technology? So adequate knowledge of material science and its fundamental must proceed the development of new and superior materials. Because if you have the adequate knowledge, then you can go further to explore the new materials. Okay. Because if I am an engineer and if I want to try a very unconventional material which had not been used in the past, I am scared somewhere. But if I know the properties, but if I know that the strength of that material is this one, the water tightness is this, the stiffness is this, the density is this, then I became much confident as compared to the previous one. So basic thing is you have to study the material science and you have to study the material engineering, or you have to test the material at engineering scales. Then only you can use that material. It also provides better understanding to the engineer and architect to judge the feasibility of new and unconventional materials. As I told you, the same thing is that if you want any unconventional material to use, you cannot judge. So material science provides the adequate knowledge or better understanding to judge the feasibility of new and unconventional materials. Understanding of the behavior of materials from a knowledge of their structure is essential, and that is why the behavior of the material from the knowledge of their structure, like what is the inner structure of that material, it is very important. And then only we can know the behavior of the materials. Information from material testing, processing, handling and fabrication should also be used along with the basic sciences to give the foundation for material technology needed for practice. If you, अगर आपने उसको टेस्ट किया है अच्छे से, जो कसौटी पे उसको आपने परखा है, और तब जाके वो मटेरियल अगर आपका ठीक है और सारे पैमानों पे खरा उतरता है, तो फिर आप उसको बहुत अच्छे से यूज कर सकते हैं कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री में. बिकॉज कंस्ट्रक्शन इंडस्ट्री इज दैट इंडस्ट्री विच नीड्स लॉट्स ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट, एंड अ सिंगल रॉन्ग डिसीजन विल कॉस्ट यू इन मिलियंस. एंड दैट इज व्हाई इफ यू वांट एनी न्यू मटेरियल टू यूज, यू हैव टू टेस्ट इट, यू हैव टू हैंडल इट. इफ यू नो हाउ टू हैंडल इट, यू नो व्हाट इज द टेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ द फैब्रिकेशन. So that is why basic sciences is very important. Now, what I told you earlier, that how we can determine or how we can explore the material. So basically there are three levels. Like first level is the molecular level or microstructure level, which sometimes you also known as nano level. The second one is the material structure level, which is, you know, like that we can see with the naked eyes, you can say. And third one is the engineering level, which is the homogeneity of, you can say the homogeneity from heterogeneity, that will tell you. So first of all, if you talk about molecular level, consideration of the molecule at the smallest scale in terms of atoms, molecules and aggregates of molecules. Like, you need sophisticated instruments or microscope to explore that structure, that level. Like, there is a microstructure of cement paste which you are seeing in the slide. So you can see how, what are the patches, what is the material, what is the means of black patches, what is that white one. So the sophistication in this level is much higher as compared to material structure, because the size of the particle in this range is 10 to the power minus 7 to 10 to the power minus 3 millimeter. So it's very important to study that microstructure of the level, because microstructure of the level determines some of the qualities. Microstructure determines porosity, microstructure determines durability to a great extent. It is the microstructure which determines you, or which tells you, or which forecasts you how durable the material is. Because the atomic bonding between two molecules or two atoms determines you what are the durability level of that material. The second one is the material structure level. So you see the surface structure of concrete wall. Now you are seeing through the naked eyes, you see the patches in the wall, you see the aggregate, you see the mortar, you see the color of the material. So consideration of a material as a composite of different faces which interact to give the total behavior. Like the material which is a, because in the civil engineering you use mostly the composite materials. You didn't use any kind of virgin material, you always use composite materials. So the material which you can see through the naked eyes, a microstructure which tells you about the surface, you can say that what is the surface of that material. Is it a rough surface or it is a slippery surface? So that level is also very important, and in this level you have a faces, like because composite, you have different material. If you want to talk about concrete, then you have aggregate, you have cement and you have sand. So you have faces of three materials. Now how the interface means the point where two faces meet. So interface is the weakest part of the material structure. So you have to think about that what is the deficiency of the interface, how we can fulfill or how we can improve the weakness in that phase. So here you see lots of plasticizers and additives comes into the existence. So it is the need of the interface which comes through the analysis or the study of the material structure level. So in that case, material structure level is also very important. The size of the particle in the range of 10 to the minus 3 to 100 mm. Now the third one is engineering level, which is very interesting. Consideration of the total material normally taken to be homogeneous and continuous. You know the concrete is not homogeneous material, it is a heterogeneous material. But in design we have to consider the concrete as a homogeneous material. So engineering level is the level which designers do. Like, they consider the concrete as a single material. And in that level, engineering level, in that homogeneous and continuous material, the concept of minimum value, I think, comes into the existence. Like, the size of the minimum value or the size of the representative unit is the minimum value that represents the entire system. Like, if the microstructure of the cement paste, so if I just a minute, sometimes So if I take this material, this portion only, then what will happen? I am unaware about that patch which is a different material or a different thing. So you have to take a certain area in which all the property of that material will be determined. You can see the aggregate, you can see the cement, you can see the mortar, everything you can see. From there you can see why the cube is 150 mm to test any material, why not more and why not less. So here are the concept, engineering level, because in that level you can see the material as a homogeneous which covers all the part of the of that material, all the aspects of that material. So these three levels are very important, level of information for materials. Another thing is that selection of modern materials. So generally there are so many selection factors, but I shortlisted some of the few. There are many more also, but what I think is that these are most important, you can say. Cost effectiveness is something that I think you all are aware of. That there is no need to tell you about that, because cost effectiveness is not something that is cheap. Cost effectiveness is something which we can get the best, we can get the best from the least. When there is a sale of 40% and 50% in a Monte Carlo showroom or in any brand, we always rush there. Why? Because we know that this is the best price I can get that material. So cost effectiveness is something which is closely associated with the technology and material science. If you have the better understanding of the material science or material technology, you can make or you can minimize the cost through those technologies. So this is very important, especially for a country like India, where the funds are limited, where the demands are very high. So you have to make this criteria to be a very important criteria. The second one is the durability. As I told you earlier, durability is something that everyone wants. Everyone wants durability. Even you want that your sleeper should be durable. So the house that I think most of the Indians build one house in his lifetime, and they want that their concrete, their beam, their column should be durable, that they can live their entire life, and even their children can live their entire life in that material, in that house. So in any project, durability is very important, and we want a durable material in that sense that they can serve the purpose, whatever period, for that, at least not for the century, but for the decade, that material should survive. And microstructure tells us most about the durability. Third one is the water tightness. And water tightness is something that is very important. If you talk about any house or any pipeline or any dam, you don't want concrete to be leaked down. You want that, yes, the concrete should withstand against the water. So water tightness is also something which I think we have to work upon a lot, because in the developed countries, you see, they did a wonderful job. They uses polymers, they uses composite to make their houses so neat and clean. Dampness is very low in the country like India, which is, I think, a tropical country. Even then, you see lots of houses full of dampness, which is, I think, the defect of workmanship and defect of material or the inferior quality of material. So these are the things I think we need to look upon that. A fourth one is environment friendly. Jai Singh Rajput sir told you the environment friendly materials. So everything nowadays, as COVID-19 full controls the damage which was happened earlier in the ozone layer, that doesn't mean that we didn't think about the environment. We have to think about the environment, we have to save the environment, and the structure that we build or the structure that we live, we want the material to be environment friendly. We want the material that they didn't harm the society. Like nowadays, we always looked upon energy efficient buildings. And why energy efficient? Because we don't want our resources to be wasted upon, or we don't want our environment to be harmed by our materials. Strength and stiffness is something very technical and very important. If you talk about any material, especially the construction material, strength and stiffness is the foremost priority, because our structure is to withstand against the load. That load may be a normal vertical load, or that may be with some kind of moment also. We have seismic loads also. So we have to withstand against any kind of load, and that is only possible by the material which has a very good strength and stiffness. The last one is the speed of construction. The speed of construction is something which I think we really look upon, because in India there is a delays in every project. We have lots of delays, and that is due to the lack of technology or lack of bureaucracy also, but that is a different part. We have to talk about only technical issues. So the technology is also very important in that speed of construction. Like you see recently, due to COVID-19 pandemic, China constructed a hospital in just 7 days or 10 days, I think, a 1,000 bed hospital. So these are the technologies that I think India needs to fulfill or to increase the infrastructure sector of our country. Now this is the table which is very important, and I would like to draw your kind attention on the fact that there is a variation in the materials. Which material has variations, which material doesn't have variations, we will look. So we have taken it from Millstone and Domon, selection of materials variability. So number one is steel. The mean strength of steel is 460 tension MPa, megapascal, and the coefficient of variation is just 2%, because it is an industrial material and the variation is very less. We want those kind of material which possesses very less variation, very less coefficient of variation. If you talk about concrete, it has a 15% coefficient of variation, and mean strength is 40 compression. And that is why, because of that variation, nowadays we are looking forward to PCC, prefabricated concrete or pre-stress cement concrete. Why? Because they are more uniform. They doesn't have that much amount of variation as compared to concrete, normal concrete, because it is made at the site, and lots of factors affect the performance of the concrete. Timber is something which has a dual property, like the ungraved softwood is the variation 35%, whereas the structural grade chipboard has only 10%. Because structural grade chipboard can be furnished in the industry, it's a grain which collectively build a plywood which is used extensively in doors, windows, bedsheet, and so many things. So the we want a variation to be very less. We want material to be uniform. Fiber cement composite is also a very new material which has a very less variation as compared to concrete. The mean strength is also less because it has a polypropylene fiber with 6% volume fraction in stress direction. So mean strength is also less, but the variation is also less. So variability is something that we have to look upon. We want the material which is more uniform, industry based, so that our performance or our requirement can be evenly met by the industry. So this is one thing. Variability is one thing that we have to think about that. So now we will compare different materials on the basis of density, stiffness, toughness, hardness, and tenacity. We discussed very little about tenacity. It is the ability of a material to resist fracture under the load of tensile load, because fracture is something which is very important. Because toughness, we need toughness, because if a material fracture, then I think it is not desirable in the construction industry. So you all know these are the very basic properties, but for people, I want to remind you that density is the degree of compactness of a substance, like how much compacted it is. Stiffness is extent to which an object resists deformation in response to an applied force, like what amount of resistance any material can respond or can avoid deformation. Toughness is the property of material which enables it to absorb energy without fracture. So we need tough material. We need material those who didn't fracture very easily. Hardness is something that is also very contradictory sometimes, that it is the ability of material to resist indentation or surface abrasion. And there are so many construction material which is very hard but not tough. So it is also came from Wilson Doman 2001. The number one is common pure metal. The density is 5 to 19 and the stiffness is 20 to 200 gigapascal. The limiting stress is 20 to 80 megapascal, whereas the fracture toughness is 100 to 1000 kilojoule per square meter. So fracture is something which I think we have to look upon that, because density is the primary factor. So we study and we talk about lot about density, but fracture is something that we also have to look upon that. Structural steel has only 7.85 density, whereas the stiffness is very much, like 195 to 2005 gigapascal. So structural steel is a very efficient construction material for civil engineering industry. The limiting stress is 235 to 440 megapascal, whereas the fracture is 100 to 130. The high strength steel has a very uniform or has a very good limiting stress. Limiting stress is the ultimate stress that any material can withstand. So the density is equal, it's 7.85, but the stiffness is on a very uniform size of 205 gigapascal, whereas the limiting stress is 260 to 1300. It's I think twice as compared to the structural steel. And work to fracture toughness is 15 to 20. So toughness is something which is very low. The cast iron is 6.9 to 7.8. The stiffness is 170 to 190, and the limiting stress is also on a very quite high side, 220 to 1000. Silica glass is a very different kind of material. It's a very new material that is in use nowadays. They are using silica glass in various industries. So we have density of 2.6, stiffness of 94 and strength or limiting stress of 50 to 200 megapascal. The toughness is very low, very quiet, 0.01, and the relative cost is also a parameter which we are talked about here. Like we assumed structural steel, the cost is 1, and on the basis of that structural steel, we are determining the relative cost per unit mass and volume. So the silica glass, the mass is on a higher side as it's a light material, so mass is more, the volume is quite same. Titanium and alloy. Titanium is a very strong material with a very less density as compared to steel. Its density is only 4.5, whereas the stiffness is 80 to 130, but the limiting stress is 180 to 1320. As compared to concrete, it has a very strong properties or has a very strong limiting stress. The relative cost is also very high, and that is why it is not generally used in construction industry, because the relative cost is almost 1000 times more than the concrete. Aluminium alloys is the density is 2.7 and stiffness is 69 to 79 gigapascal, and limiting stress is 40 to 630 megapascal. The fracture toughness is 80 to 30 kilojoule per square meter. If you talk about concrete, so concrete has a limiting stress both in tension and compression. In tension, it's very weak, so the compression limiting stress is 40 to 10 tension. Whether in compression, it's 20 to 150. And stiffness is 20 to 45. The relative cost is quite low as compared to steel, 0.7 to 0.12. As we all know that the density of the concrete is quite low as compared to steel. Epoxy resin and carbon fiber composite is the material which is very new. The density is 1.1 to 1.4, stiffness is 2.6 to 3, and limiting stress is 30 to 100, toughness is 0.1 to 0.3. So, from this table, what we understand is that we have a wide variety of material. We have different material whose densities are same. We have very different material whose stiffness are same, and very different materials whose limiting stress is also same. Like if you talk about high strength steel and titanium, the limiting stress is almost same, but the applications are very different because of the availability and the relative cost. So it depends upon the engineer that which material he is choosing or what are the factor he is assuming or he is considering for that project. Like selection of material, we have wide variety of material which is available based on our performance. Like for density, we have wood as well as metal. Wood is also equal in density as metals. And as you see in the historical buildings, wood can be used as in lintels. And even today also, some of the rural areas, they are using wood in a very efficient manner. Stiffness, we have nylon to metals. So nylon is also very stiff, and nowadays in geosynthetics, in polymers, we are using nylon in a very large extent. Strength, we have concrete to titanium. If you want a strength, you have concrete which can withstand the large bodies of water, which can withstand the large load. Like you can see the Burj Khalifa, the Empire State, the Twin Tower, they are all made up of concrete, and they are withstanding huge amount of load and the serviceability of those material is also on a very high side. But if you talk about a very fine material, there is a titanium also, but its cost is very high, and that is why it's very limited to use. But there is an option that we can use titanium also. Work to fracture, we have glass, which is very brittle to very ductile metal. So we can use glass also. Glass is very extensively used nowadays, even especially in the urban areas. Glass is a kind of material which is indispensable nowadays, if you talk about even for the architectural purpose also. Glass is something which is now totally you can say बिल्कुल बस गया है उसके अंदर. सो ग्लास इज समथिंग विच यू कैनॉट इग्नोर नाउ अडेज फॉर एज अ कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कंस्ट्रक्शन मटेरियल एंड वी हैव सो मेनी डक्टाइल मेटल्स विच वी आर यूजिंग. वी आर यूजिंग सो मेनी आई थिंक प्री फेब्रिकेटेड मटेरियल फॉर सीलिंग्स, फॉर फ्लोर फिनिशिंग्स, फॉर वॉल डेकोरेटिंग नाउ अडेज, फॉर साउंड इंसुलेशन. वी आर यूजिंग सो मेनी फाइबर्स एंड मेटल समटाइम्स. इन मैनी केसेस मोर देन वन मटेरियल इज फिट फॉर द सेम पर्पज. देर आर सो मेनी प्लेसेज वेयर यू कैन यूज वन मटेरियल, वेर यू कैन यूज मोर मटेरियल्स इन फॉर द वन एप्लीकेशन. लाइक यू कैन यूज You can use so many materials for any single work. So this is how the selection of material is important based on the properties of the materials. So this is a slide of the review of modern construction materials. Like we have, I shortlisted some of the materials which is modern nowadays, like polymers, glass, metal, and lot of work is nowadays going on. On bituminous material, now we have modified bituminous material, we have plastic we are using in bituminous material, making modified bituminous material, modified bitumen or asphalt, and we have fiber reinforced polymers and floor finishes. Nowadays you see a lot of floor finishes materials. We have, you see a very superior qualities of tiles, which is nowadays very normally available in the market. Polymers is something which changes the system of the construction materials. Like I think, like how the geosynthetics works, like it's used in the retaining wall. We are using polymers for sound insulation sometimes also. Glass, I told you earlier that glass is something which is very important. And for the, especially for the modern architecture, glass is something which you cannot ignore. Metal we are using for quite a long time. So these all are the materials I think which we should work upon, and we have to think or we have to read about those materials, and we have to incorporate these materials in our design. Lots of practice engineers are there who are listening this video. Lots of students are there who will work in the consultancies in abroad or in the designs. So you have to inculcate or you have to use those materials extensively to develop the construction technology or to develop the utilization of material in a superior way. So researchers have the researcher has a duty to explore more and more about the different materials to utilize or to you can say बहुत सारा उस पर काम करना चाहिए. यू हैव सो मेनी वेस्ट मटेरियल्स, यू हैव सो मेनी वेस्ट काइंड ऑफ प्लास्टिक एंड डेमोलिशन वेस्ट. यू हैव सो मेनी वेस्ट मटेरियल विच यू कैन इनकॉर्पोरेट. फ्लाई ऐश इज समथिंग विच इज फिनोमिनन नाउ. नाउ इट्स अ वेरी प्रेशियस मटेरियल बिकॉज द यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ फ्लाई ऐश इज सो मच दैट सीमेंट इंडस्ट्री वॉन्ट फ्लाई ऐश, ब्रिक इंडस्ट्री वॉन्ट फ्लाई ऐश. सो इट इज ओनली द रिसर्च विच डिटरमाइंस दैट फ्लाई ऐश हैज द एबिलिटी टू वर्क विद द सीमेंट. And that is why, that is the only reason it's a very important material. The picture here in my slide is, you can see the skyscraper of Mumbai, the skyline of Mumbai, Antilla is there. These all materials are not concrete, steel, timber. These kind of development needs modern materials, need polymer, glass, metal, bituminous material, fiber reinforced concrete, fiber reinforced polymers and floor finishes and many more. These are only some of the few. We need many more material to develop the construction industry in that way. So this is all about today's last lecture. We are ending this workshop on a note that the utilization of modern construction material is very important and exploration of those material is also very important. So thank you all to patiently listen all the lectures and thank you all that you registered in a very good amount, and if we have any kind of shortcomings or if any kind of because lots of young teachers are there in this lecture, so if you have any kind of shortcomings, you can forgive us for that. And your motivation is also very important. I think in future also we will talk about another topic, or we will come along with a different topic or a different seminar or something like that. So in future also I think we want your association with us, and we want a fraternity which is to be developed to share the knowledge or to share the experiences or to share the basic share the new technologies which has been coming in our industry. So thank you a lot for this. Thank you.